Welcome to Utah. Since Mercedes launched the GLS 2006, in that time it was called GL, they sold more than 500,000 units of that car. Now they present the brand new version. They say this is the S-Class in the SUV segment. But how much S-Class will this car deliver? And how much SUV will be left? With a width of 1.95 m, the GLS from the front looks very solid, very massive. And very important is we have this upright, right big grille here at the front, combined with a big star, and that gives the car character and power. And important with our car, with the AMG line, we do have great big air intakes, loads of black for contrast, and that together really provides you with a unique look. Very important is the GLS always comes as standard with multi-beam LED headlamps, and they do have a very special daytime running light. And that reminds me of the S-Class. And that should tell you, when you have that in the rearview mirror, here comes the top version of the Mercedes SUVs. Looking at the side of the car, the first thing you see how big it is, because that car now is 5.20 m in length, and that means 77 mil longer than the predecessor. And the wheelbase also has been increased by 60 millimeters. That really delivers loads of extra space at the interior. But for me, the real eye-catcher on the side are these big rims, because now you can have the car with rims from 19 up to 23 inch, and that really gives you this look. The rest of the car looks very much like a Mercedes SUV should look like. You have the long hood with these power domes on the top. You have the big glass house. You do have very high, very muscular shoulders, and you do not find any lines at the side of the car. This is typical Mercedes design. When you look at the rest, we do have from the C-pillar here, this big boot, this very, very massive shoulders, and then it just flows into the taillights. Looking at the rear of the GLS, which is one of my favorite views to the car, you really see the typical new look. The car is very solid and very massive. And one reason for this width is the part here, which looks slimmer. And the reason for that are the new splitted taillights with LED technology. And to make them so slim, they just put the reflector down here. And one thing which is important when you look at the rear of the car, you see the top of the car, and then you'd see these massive shoulders here, and then you have the claddings over the wheel arches, and that together really gives you this powerful back of the car. And normally you do have an underride protection down here, but because we drive the AMG line, you do find a diffuser. The first impression you get when you drive the GLS is that it's really extremely quiet inside of the car. You do hear a bit of the wheels, you do not hear any air. And what you do hear is the ventilation of the air condition, if it's on. And that's nearly everything. There is a bit of the engine, if you push the pedal a bit more, but this is just a very nice and smooth sound. So that car, really only because of the quietness in here, provides you with so much comfort while driving. There is one diesel engine available for the new GLS in two different versions. One delivers 286 horsepower, the other one 330. And there is the big V8 4-liter engine, which we are driving, available. This is a petrol, and that delivers 489 horsepower, 700 newton meters of maximum torque. And it features EQ boost, which means you can have, if needed, another 22 horsepower from the electric engine combined with up to 250 newton meters of extra torque. And that really gives the car the kick you want. And for people outside of the EU, there is another petrol engine available, a smaller one, a 3-liter, and that then delivers 367 horsepower. Very important with the GLS, they all come with a 9G-tronic automatic gearbox, and they all deliver, of course, all-wheel drive. My car is featuring the V8 4-liter engine, and that provides you with loads of power, and that is then combined with a 9G-tronic automatic gearbox and the all-wheel drive. And so you can really drive the car quite dynamic if you want, even though it weighs about 2.5 tons. But I think more important with this engine is that you have so much power, and combined with this 9-speed automatic gearbox, the car just drives so smooth, so easy. You never have the feeling that I do not have enough power. You always know there is loads of it, but you don't need it. And that provides you with a very smooth, very easy drive, and this really is something you would expect from an S-Class. So next to me now is Stephanie Schmidt, Head of Project Development, GLS. Stephanie, I have a question. You claim for your GLS that this is the S-Class under the SUV, but what makes the car the S-Class? What happens to the car to say, yes, this is it?
So, especially in this car, we have all the features and all the adventures an S-Class delivers to a customer. So we have the comfort in the second seat row, we have the NVH niveau comparable to an S-Class, we have the luxury and all these stuff, and we are driving on the streets like we do in a limousine, not like in an SUV in former times. So, and in addition, this car is capable to be off-roading as well. And comparable to other SUVs in this segment, it's much better, to be honest.
And when we talk about the interior and the space, what has changed there?
So we have about 80 mil more space in the second seat row. We really dedicated to the second seat row to really give the passengers in the back seats much more comfort, much more flexibility, and additional new features and technologies also for the second seat row.
And when we talk about driving off-road with that car, of course it is capable of a lot, but how did you manage to have these on-road qualities and these off-road capabilities? And even then, if you drive it off-road, it's still more smooth, more comfortable than most of the others.
Yeah, and this is thanks to EABC, which really performs on-roading with road surface scan and all this stuff perfectly, and same as in off-road. With an additional off-road application, it really makes the vehicle going up to the hills like a cat smoothing around.
The GLS should be the S-Class of the SUVs, and to be this, of course, you have to find great materials, perfect craftsmanship in the car, and that, of course, the GLS delivers. But on top of this, it must be a modern car. And so the GLS comes as standard with MBUX, so the new Mercedes infotainment system, including voice control. And on top of this, it features two 12.3-inch screens in front of me. One is a touchscreen, one is the cockpit. And if you want, you can have the new Mercedes head-up display, which you may already know from the Mercedes GLE. So, and that really gives you the idea of having a widescreen monitor in front of you on the road. So that really is very nice to look at and very nice to drive with. And when you then look around with the materials, with the craftsmanship, with the very nice sound system, the car really delivers what you expect. And on top of this, you may find up to 11 USB ports to connect your mobile devices. So really, the modern environment you want. And so I could say, regarding to this, this is the S-Class of the SUVs. There is one feature that you can buy for the GLS, which is an augmented reality system for your sat-nav. And that then combines the view of the front camera with the information from the sat-nav. And that gives you extra information when you, for instance, have to turn left or right. So you will see some errors here, which are on top of the real life picture in front of you. And that is very helpful when you have to drive in a city where you may don't know anything about the route, or if you're on a motorway and you do not know which lane should I take. And that really gives you a perfect idea of where you have to go when. Of course, Mercedes offers plenty of state-of-the-art assistant and safety systems for its flagship SUV. And so it includes an active brake assist and an active lane keeping assist, as well as a rear view camera as standard. However, the list of optional extras is endless. But in any case, I would absolutely recommend the Driver Assistant Package Plus. It enables partially automated driving and so provides significantly more comfort and safety. The GLS, of course, has to deliver loads of space, and this is what it does for the driver and co-driver. So I'm nearly 2 meters tall and I do really sit very comfortably in the car, and I did not push the seat to the maximum rear position. So it's really loads of space here. As you can see, I still have head space left. And then with the first row behind me, you can choose if you want a bench for three people or if you want to have the two single seats, and that without extra costs. And there you do really have the extra space regarding to the change in the wheelbase of the car. I think this is more than 80 millimeters more legroom down there. And behind that, you can have the car as a seven-seater, so you do have space for another two people. And I think there is enough space for even 7 adults in the car, even for a longer trip. So I think that car really delivers the space you expect from such a big SUV. So now, after a smooth and easy drive of the motorway, we arrived at the off-road track. And this is the reason why we changed cars, because I don't want to ruin that. I don't ruin the color, I don't want to ruin the rims. And this is why we take this one. Same engine, same amount of power, but if we do find some scratches afterwards, I wouldn't mind. So next to me now is Rüdiger Rutz, head of testing SUVs. Rudy, that's what I'd have to say to you. Rudy, I have a question. The new GLS really delivers a lot on and off-road. It's very comfortable on-road, but extremely here as well when we drive off-road. And one reason for that is E-Active body control for sure. And I think this active suspension does have quite a history when we talk about Daimler.
Yes, it has. It started last century with some research themes there, even our former boss, Dieter Zetsche, did his PhD thesis on this theme. So, and as all knew, our S-Class, the 220, had the first active body control system. I think this was 1998 when it came to the market. And this is the second generation here of our active body control system, driven by 4 independent electric actuators, and it's even better than the old one.
And as you see, we're really in an off-road track, because that was a motorcycle which just interrupted us during the interview. But I have a question regarding to the technology behind it. So I know that this car really does give me a feeling of a surface which is quite clean, but how does it work technically?
The system uses many sensors, like accelerations, the steering angles, the speed of the car, and also uses the camera in front. With the stereo cam, it scans the surface and it gives it to the microcontroller, which controls all the 4 struts. And in this way, it tries to keep the body of the car steady all the time.
And so that means for me, when you drive on a surface like this, this really feels a bit like being on a magic carpet. So you really do not feel most of the surface. But when we talk about driving off-road with that car, we do have some extras there, some benefits there as well.
Yeah, because this system is able to control all the 4 tire loads independently. And it spreads them in a way that the traction of the car is still there. This is essential in off-road to get further.
Yeah. And as you see, normally you wouldn't go off-road, and we will go, and we already did, really rocky grounds. And I can tell you, the GLS delivers a lot more than I expect from such a luxury car. When I have to drive a big car like the GLS, which is so heavy and which runs on these big rims, I do normally expect something like a more indirect drive, and this is absolutely not what the GLS delivers. So you really have the car under perfect control, and it does not feel like driving such a big car. It always feels lighter, more agile, and this is really something I like a lot with the GLS. So driving that car always provides you with the impression of having the car under perfect control. So now I've been off-road with the GLS, and as you can see, some I think important figures. The car features up to 30 centimeters of ground clearance. We do, of course, have all-wheel drive, and we do have a wading depth of up to 60 centimeters, which just helped me with this small river here. And important is I drove here on gravel grounds, on loose grounds, sand, grass, stony grounds, uphill, downhill. And I have to say, overall, that car here off-road really delivers a lot more than I ever expected from such a luxury car. With an entrance price of about 85,000 euros, the Mercedes GLS is for sure not a bargain. But that's not unusual in the big luxury SUV category. So probably the most important competitor, the BMW X7, costs from about 84,000 euros.
And a Cadillac Escalade starts from over 114,000 euros in Germany. But to be fair, it must be mentioned that both the Mercedes and the BMW start as a 3-liter diesel, while the American competitor has a 6.2-liter V8 on board. All seats of the GLS, by the way, can be easily folded down electrically. And so the SUV provides between 355 and 2,400 liters of loading capacity. That's almost 300 liters more than the BMW X7 offers with its maximum of 2,120 liters. An initially strange sounding but practical feature is the standard car wash mode. Here the suspension moves to the highest position to reduce the track width of the GLS. In addition, the mirrors are folded, the rain sensor is deactivated, and of course all windows will be closed.
That was my test drive with the new Mercedes GLS. And Mercedes says this is the S-Class of the SUVs. And when you have driven the car and you have enjoyed the comfortable drive, all the modern technology, all the silence in the car and all the space, you know they do not lie. And when you then take a seat at the rear seats, you enjoy comfort and loads of space. So this is, on top, a perfect chauffeur limousine. The only downside of the car is the price, because the small diesel engine, so the V6 3-liter, starts in Germany a little bit above 85,000 euros. But I think this is what you have to pay if you want the S-Class of the SUVs.